Hi fellow Webflowers! As a Webflow developer, one of the most common things we do is creating class names, and sometimes it can get pretty hard to find the right name. Just think about you create a new class and stare at the blinking cursor, thinking about the name that is descriptive, but at the same time not too long. The next question is, when do you use a dash, double dash, or underscore? Without realizing, we have decision fatigue and all the work becomes torture. Luckily, there are class naming conventions that can help you to find a better routine and system. While there are well-known CSS naming conventions like BEM, it might not be the best choice for Webflow. So in today's video, I'm going to explain you the foundation of good class naming strategies and what system you can use, so let's get into it. Basically, there are three types of class names that are important. First of all, element classes. These are classes that describe a specific HTML element, such as a button or a hero. Then second, modifier classes. These are classes that modify an element class, such as isButtonLarge or isNavScrolled. And third, utility classes. These are classes that apply a specific style, such as background blue or text align center. These three categories can be found in most CSS class naming conventions, but sometimes they are named different. So my system is based on Finsweet's client first and takes advantage of the best parts of it. First, I use custom classes, what actually is the same like the element classes for stuff like buttons, sections, cards, and so on. For example, a button will look like this, followed by a button icon and a button text class. And a section looks like this. It has an about underscore section followed by an about underscore wrap and a container and then page padding large and finally an about underscore inner. Notice when I'm using an underscore, every time you use an underscore, a folder gets created for your CSS classes. If you have the Finsweet browser extension for Chrome installed, you can click here and choose folders. And here we have our custom class folder. What makes it so handy is that you can rename the class and all its children at once. See how everything in the section that contained about before is now replaced by features? Then there are combo classes. They are actually the modifier classes and they look like this. For example, isButtonLarge. The prefix is tells me and others that it modifies the element class it is attached to. So in case of a large button, the modifier class changes the padding and the font size. But everything else, like the color, transitions, and border radius, come from the element class itself. The same works for secondary buttons. The modifier class is button secondary changes the color of the background and the text. You can even combine modifier classes to create a large secondary button like this. The advantage of modifier classes is that you build a consistent system, save up unnecessary lines of CSS, and are flexible enough to face different requirements in the design. The third type of classes are global utility classes, like text align center, for example. You can identify a global class by its structure. It only has dashes, no underscores, and they don't start with the is prefix like modifier classes. The difference between modifier classes and global utility classes is that modifier classes are the combination of two classes. So think about it like a new class where Webflow applies new styles. A global utility class adds existing styles to an element. So if you have the choice, I would always go with global utility classes just to keep your CSS file clean and don't blow it up with unnecessary combo classes. And by the way, if you find this video helpful, subscribe to my channel not to miss any of the future videos. But now, talking about combo classes. In general, you should try to avoid to overuse them because it can get hard to make style changes in other breakpoints. So for example, when you want to change the padding of a card on mobile and the paddings are applied to the card class on desktop, and you also use combo classes to give the card maybe a different background color, you will face the following problem. You will not be able to select the element class in the mobile breakpoint. Instead, Webflow jumps back to the desktop breakpoint. To adapt the paddings on mobile, you need to delete the combo class temporarily, make the change, and then re-add the combo class. One thing you should avoid without any exception is applying new styles to combo classes that contain global classes. For example, if you have text size large in combination with text weight bold, and you want it to become blue, don't do it this way. Either you use another utility class like text color blue, or you apply the style to the wrapper div, like in this example here. The reason is, the next time you, a teammate or the customer uses the combo class again, it will apply the blue color, and from here on things can get pretty messy. The next topic I want to cover is the naming itself. Just imagine a Webflow project where you have 10 different heroes and the use of the heroes is not tied to a specific page. So in this case, it can be better to go with abstract class names. So instead of naming the hero on the about page hero-about, I would go with a name like hero 1, hero 2, hero 3, if you're planning to use them on many different pages. So as a rule of thumb, I would say choose your name specific where possible and abstract where necessary. Another good example for this concept is when you look at card layouts. In most projects, you have many card layouts and they get used in different situations. So when you name a card, feature card, but later are using it somewhere else in a different context, things can get confusing. So for cards, I usually use abstract names like card 1, card 2, and so on. As always, there are many different approaches to name your classes and they all have pros and cons. But the most important thing is that you stay consistent. A lack of consistency will break any system. And in case you want to know which page structure I used, you can watch this video now. Thanks for watching, and as always, stay in the flow.